In 1991, the Hamilton Tiger Cats were front page news for all the wrong reasons. They were the CFL's laughingstock, a team without direction, without leadership, without hope. By the midway point of the schedule last year, the season was already lost. Head coach David Beckman would soon be but a memory. The new man, John Gregory, was expected to perform miracles, but not even he could turn the tabbies around. At the end of the season, there were 3 wins, 15 losses, and a lot more questions than answers. The offseason brought more turmoil, but it also brought hope in the form of Damon Allen. Like the Ticats, Allen was looking for a return to his glory days, and he's found them in 1992. He's the Damon Allen of old, the man who can single-handedly turn around a football team and a football game. The Ticats are back, and so are the fans. More than 20,000 at the home opener at Ivor Wynne Stadium. New ownership, new direction, a tie for first place. You've read all about them. Now see them for yourselves. It's the Ticats and the Eskimos, next on TSN. Game of the week on TSN. Tonight's game from Ivor Wynne Stadium in Hamilton is brought to you by Pepsi. Gotta have it. It's a gorgeous night by the lake. 16 degrees, not much wind, a dry artificial surface, and 2 red-hot football teams. The Edmonton Eskimos, who have won 2 straight, take on the Hamilton Tiger Cats, who have won 3 in a row. And it's coming up on TSN. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Ivor Wynne Stadium and the CFL Game of the Week. I'm Gord Miller. If you had said at the start of the season that Hamilton and Edmonton would have 7 wins between them at this point in the season, a lot of people would have been surprised. Some were saying Edmonton would finish last at the start of the season. Doesn't look like it. And how about Hamilton? After 5 weeks of the season, the Ticats have already equaled their win total from last year. It promises to be a great showdown tonight to kick off Week 6. And now to talk more about it, here are John Wells and Leif Pettersson.
All right, Gord, the Tiger Cats are definitely on a roll. They have 3 straight wins. There's a new attitude for football in Hamilton, and I think everyone has to give credit to John Gregory, who's done a terrific job since coming here midway through last year.
Oh, there's no question about it. You know, last September, the Hamilton Tiger Cats were a team in total disarray, absolutely going nowhere. John Gregory came in, and he has brought great organizational skills to this team. You know what I like about him, too, on game day? You know, some coaches get a little excited, and they don't really know what's going on the sidelines. John Gregory is a great tactician throughout the game, and there is no reason why this team can't finish right up in the standings in the East.
It's a very happy football team right now, and happy with the quarterback that arrived in May, a free agent by the name of Damon Allen, who has helped the Tiger Cats immensely.
Well, he's brought a style to the Hamilton Tiger Cat quarterbacking that they have really lacked in the last few years. He is mobile, he can run with the football, and, you know, he has come to a team that really desperately wanted him, so he's in a great situation. The players are so happy to have him here. Management is. He's playing well. The Ticats are playing well. Sounds like a pretty fun team to be on.
Damon Allen seems like the Damon Allen of old, and he's won 3 straight games for the Hamilton Tiger Cats. He'll try and make it 4 in a row against the Edmonton Eskimos at Ivor Wynne tonight. Kickoff on our CFL Game of the Week on TSN, just moments away. A super matchup at Ivor Wynne to kick off Week 6 in the CFL. 2 teams tied for first, the Tiger Cats in the East, the Eskimos in the West, both looking for sole possession of top spot in their divisions. The head coach is Ron Lancaster in his 2nd full year. Overall record 16-7 with the Eskimos. John Gregory, who arrived in Hamilton in August of 1991 and led the Tiger Cats to their first victory after they'd lost 8 straight games last year. He has the Tiger Cats on a roll with 3 straight wins in 1992. Paul Osbaldiston ready to get the football evening underway as the Tiger Cats kick off to the Eskimos. Good return. Out to the 50. Craig Ellis for the Eskimos. So Tracy Hamm will have super field position to begin his first offensive drive.
Tracy Hamm is off to such a great start in 1992. You know, he's almost at 60% of his passes, but I think the most impressive statistic that he brings into week six is the fact that he has thrown 13 touchdowns and given up only 6 interceptions. That is a very desirable ratio.
He is number one in touchdowns tossed. First and 10 for the Eskimos at the Edmonton 50. Ham with time to throw. Sandusky was the intended receiver, and he drew lots of coverage. Jackson was over there, along with Todd Wiseman. And Cartwright actually getting in to make the play, number 20, Rico Cartwright. The Eskimos, a veteran group up front, with one exception, Chris Morris, a rookie at right tackle.
Veteran receiving corps, Henry Williams starting at wide receiver this year, and he is averaging only about 26 yards a catch, not too bad. Michael Soles, Blake Marshall, all Canadian running backs, and Michael Soles, boy, you don't lose a thing when he starts.
Williams to the far side of the field, Sandusky flanks to the near side, and Ham gets pressured, he is down. Brett Williams, number 91, meets his old quarterback in the backfield.
John, you and I talked about that in the CFL report. Would be very interesting to see how Brett Williams would play tonight. Hey, they said he was too old in Edmonton. They didn't want to bring him to training camp. So he found a job in Hamilton, and he is very eager to show his former teammates that he still has a few sacks left in him. He beat Chris Morris, the rookie. That is a matchup we're going to watch tonight and follow with great interest. But for the Toaster, pretty nice start in the first series.
This is Williams' third game with the Tiger Cats. Glenn Harper on third down for the Eskimos. Good kick. And the return out near the 25. There is a penalty marker down. David Lucas on the return for the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Referee tonight, Jake Ireland, in his 14th CFL season. It'll be first and 10 for Damon Allen and the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Cats begin at the 33. Lee Knights, number 25. Joined by Orville Lee in the backfield up front. Boulanger, Francois Boulanger, number 60, is the new member of the Tiger Cats offensive line.
I think where Hamilton has improved their offense so much this year is the maturity of a receiving corps. Nick Mazzoli and Ken Avrera are both off to great starts. And, of course, the same Canadian backfield as Edmonton has tonight with Orville Lee and Lee Knight.
The gain is 6, second and 4. Allen dumps it off. Orville Lee made the catch, lost the ball, but I think he was down. Willie Pless made the tackle, number 39. Tough to find a better defensive player in football in the CFL anywhere right now.
He is pretty active, Willie Pless, but this is the feature of the Ticats that they haven't had in the past. Damon Allen bought a little extra time with his scrambling. Now, they don't get the first down, obviously, but this is why they are a much improved football team. Damon Allen will make that offensive line better with his mobility back in the pocket, avoiding sacks.
Paul Osbaldiston. Not a good kick for Osbaldiston. Finally bouncing to Henry Williams at the 30. And nowhere to go as the flag goes down. Loss of 2 on a 40-yard punt. Three-man front for the Eskimos with Goods, Davidson, and Lewis up front. Solid through the middle. Blue, Pless, Ruck, and Odom. And this is the secondary that Ron Lancaster found last year when he had so many injuries. Finally, he's got everybody healthy and all those guys back there. Lyons, Jackson, Murphy, Jordan, and Thomas played part of last season in Edmonton. But part of the season they were on the injury list. On first down, Blake Marshall gets the call. Met by the toaster, number 91.
Big front four. You've got Mark Hall and Joe Fields at over 300 pounds. The toaster already, Brett Williams with a sack today. Terry Wright is actually a defensive back playing linebacker, and there you see the defensive backfield. So actually Hamilton going with six defensive backs.
4 yards for Marshall, second and six. And Ham overthrows Blake Marshall, number 22, at the far side.
You know, Hamilton can be a very frustrating team to play against. They like to rush basically four men, their front four, and then what they'll do is drop eight people deep and play a very basic zone coverage. The fact is, though, they play that zone exceptionally well. They're very disciplined back there. John Gregory likes that style of a defense, and what it does is force the offense into completing a lot of passes to move the ball and get yardage against that defense. Tracy Ham will have to be very patient tonight.
Glenn Harper standing back near his 5-yard line. Great first effort, 58 yards. This one not nearly as deep. Lucas. Good move by Lucas. He's at midfield and stopped there, lost the ball. But the Tiger Cats maintain possession.
Parrish made the tackle.
No score so far at Ivor Wynn. The Tiger Cats and the Eskimos begin week six in the CFL. Leif, you know, John Gregory turned things around for the Tiger Cats when he joined the team last year. They were 0-8. He went in against the Argos here at Ivor Wynn and won the Tiger Cats' first game of last season. And this year, you get the Tiger Cats rolling again. First of this three-game win streak was against the Argos.
Well, you know, he's an exceptional coach. He fell into a bad situation in Saskatchewan. They weren't winning, so they made a change. But Hamilton was very lucky to have him come as their head coach. And, you know, I mentioned in the opening, he brings a tremendous stability to this organization. He assesses talent very well, and he has full command on the sidelines. And his teams are usually very well disciplined, and I think that's been one of the main features of the Ticats over their first five games. They have played with a great discipline. On the other side, Ron Lancaster's second year as the head coach of the Eskimos, I think he's matured on the sidelines. And their first five games, he is making better decisions as a head coach. He's making them quicker, and I'm sure he would admit that he is much more comfortable this year than he was last year.
Yeah, he says he's a little more comfortable and enjoying it a little bit more. He had quite a start last year. Remember that first game in Saskatchewan where the Rough Riders ran back a couple of kicks for touchdowns early? Here's Allen. And not quite a first down as Allen worked his way up near the 45.
Damian Lyons made the tackle.
There's no question that Damon Allen brings a new dimension to the Hamilton offense. You'll recall last year with Mike Kerrigan and Todd Dillon, pretty basic drop back passers and a pretty easy target for pass rushers. Now the defenses have a lot more to think about when they play against Damon Allen. Will he throw? Will he run? And he can certainly keep a defense guessing, and his running will be a huge asset to this offense.
Second down for the Tiger Cats at the Eskimo 47. Second and a couple. Miscue in the Ticat backfield. Orville Lee was supposed to get the ball. Jason Riley, number 58, the right guard, coming up with the ball.
You know, that's really unfortunate. You only get so many opportunities in a game to score, and especially against a good defense like Edmonton. There was a perfect opportunity. You've got second and two. You assume you're going to pick it up, and then to have a miscue and now have to punt. I mean, those things can wear on you.
Osbaldiston standing at the Ticat 45. Eddie Thomas back at his own two. Not much blocking for Thomas, and leading the tacklers, Mark Dennis, number 49. So the Tiger Cats pin the Eskimos deep. 9:42 to go in the opening quarter so far. No score at Ivor Wynn.
Well, as Tracy Ham comes in, One thing he has to keep in mind tonight is that he knows Hamilton will play a lot of zone defense. Now what he has to do is try to get his backs involved in the passing game. That means short passes into the flat, three-man patterns where the slot backs and wide receivers clear out. The backs go in the flat. What he wants to do is throw enough and complete enough short passes to draw that zone up. Then he can start to work deeper.
From the Eskimo 6, first and 10, Edmonton. Marshall, and the Tiger Cats read it well. The toaster was there. So was Jeff Fields and Mark Hall, those two giant-sized interior linemen. The tackles on the Ticats.
And a very difficult place for Edmonton to attack. I mean, do you want to go at Mark Hall and Jeff Fields that are a couple of 300-pounders? They decide they will straight up the middle, and absolutely nothing there. So the Hamilton Tiger Cat defense in a very good spot here early in the first quarter.
A gain of 1, 2nd and 9. And to his right. He takes off himself and comes up short of the first down. Slowed down at the 15.
Lawson and Wright combining for the stop.
The Eskimos had hoped to run a little bit against the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Now some confusion on the sidelines as to what team the Eskimos want in there.
They're going to go for it.
Third down, less than a yard to go.
Pretty big gamble from your own 15-yard line.
Third and one, the Eskimos have missed this opportunity 5 times this year. Big play with 8:20 left in the opening quarter. Markers are down. Did you notice who moved first down there? Pretty tough to tell.
Really was. Oftentimes that offside against the defense in a situation like that is just the fact that they don't give a yard. They line up inside that 1 yard restraining zone.
Offside. Hamilton number 35. First down.
John Zeidel, number 35, backup linebacker. So the Eskimos come out of it with a first down, and that's the first down of this evening of football at Ivor Wynn. Three receivers to the near side for the Eskimos. Michael Soles met by John Moten. He was the Tiger Cats rookie of 1991, star of week 9 in 1991 as well. 2 interceptions, 5 sacks. The loss is 2, 2nd and 12. Ham gets more pressure, he got away. But not enough for the first down. Barely back to the original line of scrimmage.
Well, Hamilton defense, very tough.
Yeah, that front four is doing it all, too, and it was number 94, David Bailey, from the right end position. He just simply beat the block of Blake Dermott, and he was in on Tracy Ham so quickly that Ham had no choice but to run with the football, and then, of course, he was duck soup for the other fellas waiting for him. Hamilton Tiger Cat defense, awfully impressive here in the first quarter.
Back up, T6.
Glenn Harper standing at his 5-yard line. High kick coming down near the 40. Earl Winfield, number 1. Winfield roamed to the outside. Markers are down as Winfield has one man to beat. Harper slowed him down. He was caught from behind by Michael Soles, but there are penalty markers aplenty. Penalty goes against the Tiger Cats, holding the indication from Jake Ireland. It will be a Tiger Cat first down when we return to Ivor Wynn and Hamilton. 6:08 to play in the opening quarter. And so far, the zeros are still on the board.
So far, Hamilton's defense has been nothing short of spectacular against the Edmonton running attack. The reason, say the Tabbies, is none other than number 91, Brett Williams, who is playing up a storm against his former team. Maybe he knows a few pages from the playbook.
Yeah, he might remember a thing or two. He was in Eskimoville 1 year ago.
Well, he is a good one, and I'm glad to still see him around. You know, I understand Edmonton's position either. You know, at some point in time, they have to make a personnel decision. Do we bring an older veteran to camp, or do we just make a decision and go with a younger guy? They went with a younger guy. I think I understand it. I think Brett Williams understood it, but he is very happy to be a Hamilton Tiger Cat. Says he's really enjoying the city of Hamilton.
Allen in trouble.
David Allen was trying to set up a screen pass, but Rob Davidson, number 96, and a host of other pass rushers were in there so quickly that Allen really had no chance to pick out. Looked like Orville Lee was trying to sneak into the middle there, and they just were never able to get that play on track at all.
Pressure from Benny Goods, number 40, as well. It'll be second and 10, Ticats at the 35, 5:39 to play in the opening quarter. So far, no score at Ivor Wynn. Allen has time to throw this time. First down. Paul or Nick Mazzoli, number 80, first catch of the night.
And Murray Rock. Well, it's pass protection, the key to this play. Damon Allen has all kinds of time to wait for Nick Mazzoli to come all the way across the field from his slot back spot. He just found an open spot, got into it. Allen delivered, and the Ticats pick up what I believe is their initial first down of this game. Nick Mazzoli off to a good start. Originally, the number one pick in the draft last year from Simon Fraser.
From midfield, first and 10, Ticats. Winfield can't hang on the sideline. Winfield with 446 yards through five games and five touchdowns receiving.
Yeah, his numbers are very impressive. This is a good matchup tonight against Eddie Lee Thomas, who is a very, very good one-on-one corner man, and we will certainly follow that development for you. Earl Winfield averaging over 21 yards a reception so far. That is outstanding. But this guy, he's pretty good too, Eddie Thomas.
He has four interceptions so far in 92. Second and 10 for Allen and the Ticats from midfield. Man open far side, Paul Bushy. Another Ticat first down.
Great idea by Damon Allen to use the backs. Watch how Paul Bushy will just kind of sneak through the line and get out here. Now when the linebackers drop into coverage, that's when you have to hit your backs out of the backfield, and this is a good read by Damon Allen. Look at all the room that Paul Bushy has now to the outside, and boy, that's good selection. Back-to-back first downs for the Ticats.
A 20-yard gain on that one, setting the Tiger Cats up with a first down at the Eskimo 35. Allen takes off himself. Got one block, and he's almost to the 20. Stephen Jordan made the tackle.
Well, there's no question he makes this team a better team by his running ability. You know, the offensive line for the most part has protected pretty well for the past here in the first quarter, but when the opportunity presents itself, Damon Allen will run with the football, and boy, it just puts so much pressure on the defense. Do I leave my man to come up and help with the tackle, or what should I do? He puts them in a real bind.
24-yard gain at his first and 10 as Lee Knight carries and looks to the end zone. He'll score. For Lee Knight's first touchdown of the season.
But a beautiful hole for Lee Knight to run through. A huge hole, in fact. And Lee Knight, who doesn't get a chance to handle the football too often, makes the most of his opportunity. They get their first touchdown. That's a good drive.
Osbaldiston adds the single points. Lee Knight, the hero of the moment in Steeltown. Another look as Lee Knight gets his first touchdown of 1992, and the Tiger Cats jump out in front of the Eskimos. It's 7-0 on our game of the week.
You know, the Hamilton Ticats are not noted as a rushing team, but they make the most of this opportunity. Here is Willie Plest. He is coming on a stunt here. They double team down right here on Rob Davidson. Kick out here. Lee Knight, thanks very much. Touchdown. That's what you do. You attack the bubble and a three-man line. There's the hole right there. Willie Plest takes himself out of the play with the blitz, and the Ticats have a touchdown. Nicely blocked.
7-0 Ticats on the return for the Eskimos. Ezar out to the 35 and the 36. Stop there. Blake Ezar in his first season with the Eskimos from Michigan State.
Rydell and Nurse making the tackle.
An impressive drive for Damon Allen. A 21-yard rush by Lee Knight finished it off. Six plays, 75 yards, just under 3 minutes.
So it took them a couple of series, but they finally got on track, and Lee Knight, that's a great run. He's laughing about it. He said, hey, did you see how I dragged that guy about 5 yards into the end zone? And boy, they should give me the ball more often.
Absolutely. The Eskimos' chance to reply. First and 10 Edmonton from the 37. From the shotgun, Ham, Blake Marshall. Well defense by the Tiger Cats as Bobby Dawson, number 27, moved up from his left halfback spot.
Bobby Dawson got a little help from Terry Wright on that play too, but Blake Marshall, now he just sneaks in there, and now he gets out in the flat for the screen pass. He's got Randy Ambrosi and Rod Conop out in front. The only trouble is Bobby Dawson just knifed right between them and made a heck of a play.
A loss of 1 second and 11 again from the shotgun. Ham, near side. Michael Soles, short of the first down, stopped at the 40. Terry Wright, number 7. Stopping Soles that time. Had a little help from Todd Wiseman.
You know, this is a great play on first down. It's just a little tough when it's second and 10 when you hit your back about 1 yard over the line of scrimmage. A defense that's in a zone coverage has all kinds of time to react to it. Terry Wright comes up and makes the tackle. Edmonton once again has to kick. Chris Morris, the young tackle from the University of Toronto. Now, he was beaten early by Brett Williams, but that time pretty good footwork to keep Williams in front of him on that pass rush.
Enter Glenn Harper. A couple of big kicks tonight. David Lucas. Lucas, a good move down the sidelines. And a face masking call against Odom. Dwayne Odom, number 36. Seven nothing for the Tiger Cats with a minute 36 to go. Opening quarter.
Face mask. Edmonton number 36. First down.
Well, I don't think there was any question about this one.
No question about it.
Good move here by David Lucas to get around Doug Parrish. And then Dwayne Odom will come into your picture. And, well, he got some shoulder pad, but he got just enough of the face mask that the officials will call it. Even if it's close and maybe not intended, they're going to call it anyway.
From the Tiger Cat 46, Allen in some difficulty. Finally surrounded. And he'll lose about a yard.
Lloyd Lewis, who had a tremendous game for the Edmonton Eskimos last week from the defensive end spot, again with really, really good, quick initial pressure, and that totally destroyed any plans of Damon Allen. Once again, he had to run for his life. This time, he didn't get back to the line of scrimmage, but Lloyd Lewis, of course, was asked to take a pay cut by Ottawa, decided to be a free agent, and well, the Edmonton Eskimos really filled a void when they were able to sign him in the offseason.
Second and 11, the Tiger Cats. at their own 45. Winfield with the near side. Allen looks the other way. He'll have a first down. Nick Mazzoli, number 80. Second big catch of the night for Mazzoli.
This is a design play that the Hamilton Ticats have for tonight. If Mazzoli and Enos Jackson, if he's on the outside, Mazzoli cuts to the middle really quickly. Damon Allen is looking for this. There you see Enos Jackson gives him the inside. Dan Murphy, the middle safety, is nowhere to be found. This is exactly a design play that Hamilton wanted to use against Edmonton.
13-yard gain on first down, Lee Knight. And he's barely across the 50 to the 49 of the Eskimos.
Hamilton has an offensive scheme that they like to call a search scheme. And what that tells all the receivers on search is, hey, if the guy plays you to the inside, you break to the outside. If he plays you on your outside shoulder, you break to the inside. The receivers know it. Damon Allen knows it. And what it really does is simplify the passing game and maximizes your opportunity to get open.
The gain is 3. Damon Allen faces 2nd and 7. Final play of the opening quarter. Allen, they try and get it all himself. He does. Yards to spare. He's inside the Eskimo 35. Willie Pless, number 39, put the stop on Damon Allen. And that will be the end of the opening quarter in Hamilton, with the hometown Tiger Cats leading the Eskimos by a touchdown. It's 7-0. A postcard picture from Hamilton. Dear Mom, we're having a wonderful time at Iverwind tonight. Isn't that a beautiful sunset?
That is pretty. And I'll tell you what's pretty. It's the way the Hamilton Tiger Cats are performing tonight. They look sharp.
Another first down for the Tiger Cats, and it took them too long to get the ball in play on the opening play of the second quarter. Procedure call.
Procedure. Hamilton number 58. Still first down.
Numbers from the opening quarter favor the Tiger Cats on the scoreboard, as well as in the statistical columns, with 118 total yards. The Eskimos led in time of possession. The Tiger Cats have the 7-0 advantage. Procedure call against Riley, and it's 1st and 15 for the Tiger Cats. Now back at the Edmonton 40. Allen unloaded in a hurry, intending it for Paul Bushy, number 33. Number 60, Francois Boulanger, is the one newcomer on the Hamilton Tiger Cats offensive line. He played just one game for the Tiger Cats in 1991, his fifth start in 92. And he's a member of McGill's Vanier Cup team in 1987. Victory over the UBC Thunderbirds. 2nd and 15. Intercepted. Right into the hands of Damian Lyons, who streaks down the sidelines, was forced out by Paul Bushy. And a mix-up between quarterback and receiver on that play. I believe David Lucas was the intended receiver, number 82.
Well, David Lucas was in the area. Unfortunate thing is he did a hook and go. Damon Allen thought he was just staying on the hook, obviously. And the recipient of this pass is Damon Lyons with his 2nd interception of the season. And really, pretty easy one for him. David Lucas completely down the field, and Damon Allen threw it right into the arms of Lyons. So what had been a pretty impressive first half with the Hamilton Tiger Cat offense now results in the first turnover of the night.
The Eskimos are 1st and 10, just inside Ticat territory at the 53, and more markers are down. Procedure against the Eskimos.
Procedure. Edmonton number 54. Still first down.
That's Pierre Vercheval, number 54.
As well as that Hamilton Tiger Cat defense has been performing tonight, Tracy Hamm does not want to get himself in too many of these situations. 1st and 15, this is a tough defense to operate against.
Another marker down. Hamm to the far side. Henry Williams makes the catch and steps out. It'll be enough for a first down. But they'll bring it back on the other side of the offensive line this time. Chris Morris feeling a little heat from Brett Williams, perhaps.
I think so.
Number 60, still first down.
No, Brett Williams is so quick coming off the football, and Chris Morris, the right tackle, well, he knows that, and he's seen Williams go by him already once tonight, so he just simply got a bit of a head start, came out of his stance too early, shaking his head. He knows it's a mental mistake, and he knows he's going to get yelled at when they watch the films tomorrow.
First and 20, and another miscue.
Edmonton number 8, still first down.
Penalties are driving the Eskimos back to their own zone after the turnover that set them up at midfield.
Well, the unfortunate part is there's not too many plays in the playbook designed for first and 25.
That's true.
You know, you hope to maybe on first down they'll get 10 of it back and then maybe 15 on the second down, but no offense can function properly in, when you're giving up yardage like this.
The Eskimos are back to the 42. Ham takes it out of the shotgun. Looks to the far side. Williams can't make the catch. He was out of bounds. Coverage by Rico Cartwright.
And Rico Cartwright made a very calculated gamble. He knew Williams was running out of sideline to run his pattern, so he said, well, I'm going to cut underneath, and the worst that's going to happen is I'm going to get an interception, or Tracy Ham's going to have to throw it over my head, and it'll be out of bounds. See, there's Cartwright underneath right now. That is a good defensive play for a player who was a wide receiver with Hamilton last year. They felt he was better knocking down balls than catching them.
He played six games in 91. Here's Ham, second and 25. Did Williams make the catch? No. So after the turnover, the Eskimos lose 15 yards and will have to kick it away.
And I think that series ended pretty much as we would expect it would at first and 25. That is just too tough to try and convert. Yeah, they're having a good time here in Hamilton. Good crowds at the beginning of this season. They have rallied around their football team.
What's the slogan? Restore the roar?
I like that.
Yeah, I do too. Nice average for Glenn Harper tonight. David Lucas. Looking for room to the far side, finds a seam, penalty marker down, and so is Lucas. Cut from behind by Michael Soles. Looks like a blocking infraction against the Tiger Cats. We'll sort it all out when we return to Ivor Wynn Stadium, where the Tiger Cats have a 7-0 lead on the visiting Edmonton Eskimos. You're watching the game of the week on TSN.
Big meeting on the Edmonton Eskimo sideline for the defense before it just took the field. They feel that Damon Allen is running away from Leroy Blue whenever he runs, so he's running to what they call the weak side or the short side of the field. There's a problem for the Eskimos, though. Blue is bothered by a condition called pubitis. It's where the upper leg meets the hip bone, and it's very painful for him to play on artificial turf, and he's having a little problem with it right now.
Good inside information on Leroy Blue. The infraction was against Mark Dennis. And the Tiger Cats will begin this sequence. First and 10 back at the 12.
Going back to Gord's comments on Leroy Blue, he does have that problem. They do give him a considerable amount of time off during the week to get feeling better, and I think that's been a very good idea this year. You know, after five games, he has four sacks, so he is functioning at a very high level when he's in there, although he does play with pain.
Arbel Lee. Out near the 15.
I like John Gregory's comments tonight on our CFL report show. He said, look, Canadian-American, Orville Lee was simply the best tailback we had in training camp, and I think that speaks very highly of Orville Lee. You know, former Rookie of the Year in the CFL back in 1988 when he was a first pick by the Ottawa Rough Riders. I know John Gregory likes him. He had him out in Saskatchewan.
He rushed for 1,075 yards in his first season. Picked up three there. This is second and seven. Allen unloads in a hurry, intending that for Lee Knights. Ticats on third down, forced to kick it away deep in their own zone. Hamilton leading 7-0.
Well, this is a point in the game now into the second quarter where the Edmonton Eskimos have to get in the swing of things. Offensively, they really have not functioned too well, and they are going to get a wonderful opportunity with the ball around midfield to let Tracy Ham start to get things rolling.
Henry Williams at the 45. He's healthy. Bothered by a hamstring, and Williams gets it to midfield. Tackle made by Mark Dennis. Eskimos will have excellent field position when we return to Ivor Wynn. Edmonton trailing by seven. Tickets to the 1992 Grey Cup will be on sale as of this Friday at noon Eastern time. You can pick up Grey Cup tickets at Ticketmaster outlets from coast to coast. I think it's a pretty good idea, giving fans equal access to Grey Cup at SkyDome.
I think it certainly is, and yes, you're right. SkyDome will be the venue for the 1992 Grey Cup. Plans are in the work to make it a very, very interesting and exciting week. And of course, Jed Roberts, as you see right there on your screen, would love his Edmonton Eskimos to be a part of it. They're in tough in the West, though. Calgary Stampeders playing well. Saskatchewan, big win last week. They're on the upsurge.
Ticats lead it by seven. The Eskimos are first down right near midfield. Ham gets some pressure. And there was no one open. Blake Marshall was the nearest Eskimo receiver. And Ham has had to deal with quite a bit of pressure tonight.
Well, here's the problem. Tracy Ham is expecting Hamilton to play zone on first down. That is their tendency. But what did they do? They played man-to-man coverage. Terry Wright was right on Blake Marshall as soon as he gets out in the flat. There you see it right there on your screen. That's who Tracy Ham wanted to hit quickly. And when he was not open, that was the end of that pattern. But see, that's good Hamilton defense, changing up their tendency. You know, all week Edmonton's thinking, hey, zone on first down, maybe second down now, 50-50 zone man. They changed it up. Ham was confused, had to throw the ball away.
Numbers not terrific for Tracy so far. Second and 10, 10:26 till halftime, with the Ticats leading 7-0 from the shotgun. Ham over the middle, Ellis, the intended receiver. Craig Ellis with 22 receptions, 380 yards, and one touchdown so far. Averaging 17.3 per reception, but no catches tonight.
You see Tracy and Craig Ellis talking, going off the field. The worst thing for a quarterback is to start guessing, and I honestly feel like Tracy Ham at this point is guessing what Hamilton's going to do to him. They totally have him and the entire offense out of sync.
Harper stepping across the 45 to get this third down punt away. Nick Mazzoli at the Ticat 15. Good seam for Mazzoli. He has got great speed and one man to beat. Harper can't get there. Yes, he does. Looked like Mazzoli lost his footing at the 20. It was enough for Harper to catch him from behind. But a great return by Nick Mazzoli. 79 yards.
The Hamilton Tiger Cats are doing some very good things here in the first half. Everybody working hard to get a block on those special teams, and you don't need much to provide Nick Mazzoli with the lane with his speed. But how about Glenn Harper? Give him some credit. He was able to get back and trip up Mazzoli, but hey, what was a great return. Looks like it's coming back.
Offside. Hamilton number 26, still third down.
Ricky Royal. I didn't see a marker on the play.
No, I didn't either. Ricky Royal is the sixth defensive back, the designated import tonight, and obviously he was lined up offside.
The Ticats are furious, gentlemen. They felt that one of the Eskimo upbacks, Michael Soles, moved first and therefore should have an illegal procedure against Edmonton.
The Eskimos will get another chance. Harper. This time it's Lucas. And the return is limited by Pierre Vercheval.
That's so unfortunate for a team. I mean, what a 79-yard punt return. Now you get an 8-yard return, and, well, you give up a lot of yardage. John Gregory, obviously, is not too pleased.
Ticats try and regroup. They lead it 7-0, 9:14 to go until halftime. Ticats have won 3 in a row. The Eskimos have won twice in succession. Flank to the near side. David Lucas. Winfield to the far side of the field. The handoff goes to Orville Lee, and markers are down once more. Against the Tiger Cats. Holding.
Hamilton, number 56, decline, second down.
The Hankies have been out in full force tonight.
Certainly have. Dale Sanderson caught that time. Twelve already. The Eskimos have been penalized for 15 yards more. Second down, and Allen had nowhere to go, so the Tiger Cats get set to kick again. Cats have been averaging 32 points per game through their first 5 regular season games.
Now, Larry Ruck and Willie Pless, the two inside linebackers, do an excellent job coming on the blitz. Here's Larry Ruck up on the line of scrimmage, and he is able to get by Darrell Harley quickly. Now, Benny Good's number 40 will get the sack, but with so many people getting a good push straight up the middle, Damon Allen just simply had no place to go.
Paul Osbaldiston standing right on his goal line. Henry Williams takes it at the 47. Williams finds some room to the near side. He's to the 50, caught from behind by Lee Knight. Again, the Eskimos begin with outstanding field position. Well, you get to see the Giz at halftime on the Entertainers. Going against a couple of Argos. A little diving exhibition by Henry.
He is good. He is very good. He's a tremendous athlete.
From the Ticat 49, Edmonton first and 10. Ham stands in. Marshall makes the catch. He gets the first down. Simply pushed out. He's a tough guy to bring down.
Well, he really is, and this is exactly what Tracy Ham has to do. Okay, Hamilton changed up this time. Zone first down. What do you have to do? You have to throw underneath it. Get it out to Big Blake Marshall. He's waving. He's saying, hey, give it to me quick. Good move to get around Dwayne Simmons right there. And he picks up a first down. Tracy has to do that. Be patient.
First down. Open is Armstrong. Slowed by Wiseman. But he's inside the Tiger Cat 15. Chris Armstrong, 14 receptions, 316 yards, 5 TDs.
Okay, here's how the zone works. There's Moten back here, Simmons right here. Armstrong just works into the open area. Tracy Ham steps up with good protection, finds him nicely, but that's how you work as a receiver, into the zone. See that big area? Nice catch, nice pattern by Chris Armstrong.
Eskimos' deepest penetration of the evening from the Tiger Cat 14. Allen looking for Armstrong again. He drew double coverage, and Ham overthrew his receiver.
Well, it was the right read by Tracy Ham, though. He was expecting when Hamilton gets backed up, they will come with the blitz to try and help themselves. Ron Lancaster remembers that from all his great years of being a quarterback. But that is an opportunity to hit the post over the middle. Ham read it perfectly. Armstrong was open. He just sailed the ball a little too far.
Second and 10. Eskimos at the Tiger Cat 14. Edmonton trailing by a touchdown. With all kinds of time, steps up to the 4-yard line for Craig Ellis, met there by Bobby Dawson.
Nice job by Tracy Ham to wait, step up, and at the last second he's able to spot Craig Ellis coming over the middle. Bobby Dawson with the good hit. Ellis able to hang on and make the catch, and Edmonton Eskimos pick up a first down. This is obviously the best drive they've been able to put together tonight. They're trying desperately to tie this one up.
Three cracks at it from the 3-yard line. First and goal to go. Marshall. Touchdown. Blake Marshall. Fifth touchdown of the season. Along the ground, he has one more receiving, so that's number 6 for Blake Marshall.
Boy, he has a load now. What a good block by the center, Rod Conop, too, on Mark Hall. He just put him back. And remember, Mark Hall's over 300 pounds. Blake Marshall at 230 pounds, able to power his way into the end zone. And the Eskimos cap off what was a very impressive drive. What could result in tying.
It is all even on Sean Fleming's converts. So Marshall carries for the touchdown. The Eskimos finish off a great drive that began around midfield. And we're all even now at Ivor Wynn and Hamilton as Marshall gets the Eskimos on the board.
You know, we always talk about high-tech football, but really the Hamilton Tiger Cats are playing very old-fashioned ball. They've set up the Eskimos with running on first down. Now look for them perhaps to go over the top a little bit with play-action passes. Why leave? Goes all the way back to your days.
Oh, I like that style, Gord. Sounds pretty good to me. Play action, throw it downfield. I like it.
A couple of running backs have the touchdown so far tonight. Lee Knights, Blake Marshall, 7-7 in Hamilton. Boy, he's a tough guy to bring down, really. No doubt about it. When he took the ball at the 3-yard line.
Go back and Blake Marshall straight up the middle, but watch as Tracy Ham hands off. There's Rod Conop, 67. Watch the job that he does. They kick out here, and I mean, this is just good, serious blocking up front. Rod Conop, an all-Canadian center, and oh, what a block he made.
Here's the kickoff. Taken by Wright. Number 7. Cuts it up. And he's across the 35 to the 38.
Chris Johnstone making the tackle.
The Eskimo scoring drive. 4 plays to cover 49 yards. Finished off by the Blake Marshall run. Toaster has been a factor in his 3rd game for the Tiger Cats. First against his former mates in Edmonton. Okay. From the 37, first down, Damon Allen. He'll carry himself and paid the price that time, surrounded by 3 Eskimos. Davidson was there, and so was Willie Pless.
Well, that was the play action that Gord Miller alluded to. The only trouble was Willie Pless wasn't fooled. Neither was Rob Davidson. Watch Pless. He's in the middle of your screen, and as Damon Allen cuts to the inside, Pless is waiting for him. Good coverage downfield, forced Allen to run with the football, and then he took a pretty good whack.
Gain is 2, 2nd and 8. David Lucas to the near side. Earl Winfield, far side of the field. Allen will have the first down. And lots to spare. He's inside the 45. Stephon Jordan with the tackle.
Well, when it opens up the middle like that and a receiver isn't widely open, Damon Allen will run with it. This is a great run. Good play. And well, once again, it's such a difference to see Hamilton with a running quarterback this year, and their offense certainly is much better for it.
32 yards for Damon Allen sets the Tiger Cats up at the Eskimo 42. Back against the flow, intending that for Lee Knight, number 25.
Run 55 search 48.
You got the inside dope.
Yeah, we talked about earlier in the game, the search routes are simply for the receivers. You know, whichever side the defensive back is playing you, go the opposite way. So primarily an inside pass pattern to Ken Rivera or Nick Mazzoli. That's who they would like to hit.
Second and 10, Tiger Cats. Mazzoli makes the catch. That'll be a Hamilton first down. Enos Jackson, number 29, on the tackle. And Willie Pless was in the vicinity, too.
Nick Mazzoli, nice move to get to the outside against a pretty good one-on-one guy in Enos Jackson, but he just read it to the outside, and Jackson had inside position, so he went to the outside.
Enos Jackson, the steadiest member of the Edmonton Eskimo secondary, according to Ron Lancaster. 3:04 to play till halftime. It's all even in Steeltown. The Eskimos 7, the Ticats 7. Milovich and the Lions look for their first win of the season against the Saskatchewan Roughriders.
Now, do you think the Blue Bombers are going to be in a bit of a nasty mood when the Argonauts come to town tomorrow night?
I would think so.
Yeah. They did not play well in Toronto last week, and no question we'll be looking to avenge that loss. Saskatchewan will try and make it two in a row out in B.C., and of course, as you mentioned, B.C. desperately trying to get their first win of the year.
Here it's all even at 7. The two teams fighting to grab sole possession of top spot in their respective divisions. Eskimos currently tied with the Calgary Stampeders, and the Tiger Cats even with Winnipeg.
Fun to watch the two inside receivers of the Ticats, Kenny Abrera and Nick Mazzoli. The two of them have really matured there. They have more confidence. They're running better pass patterns, and they're making themselves better targets for Damon Allen.
First and 10 Ticats from the Eskimo 29, and Allen was off target on that toss. Interesting when you look at this Tiger Cat offense. Only three import players on the offensive lineup. The quarterback Allen and two outside receivers, David Lucas and Earl Winfield.
Bit of a trend. Everybody's so concerned about stopping the other team that the defenses are being stacked up with a lot of imports these days.
Come on, Damon!
Oh! I don't know if Gregory likes this call on second and 10. 2:52 to go to the half. Ticats from the 29 of the Eskimos. Allen on target, Earl Winfield. Lost the ball after he went down. It trickled into the end zone. It'll be Hamilton football. It was whistled dead after the Winfield catch.
Here's how teamwork works in a passing game. You're going to see Ken Abrera. He clears out. Winfield comes down and across the middle. But this is one teammate trying to help out the other. Kenny Abrera clears it out. There it is. Now there's an open spot for Winfield to come in. Damon Allen steps up with a good strike. And once again, the Ticats are on the move.
22-yard gain for Winfield. It is first and goal to go for the Ticats at the 7. And nowhere to go as Benny Goods burst through to grab Damon Allen.
Damon Allen, no chance to get this ball off. He knows he has to throw quickly, but he just can't get it away quickly enough. Benny Goods just slips the block of Francois Ballanger. And he is in with the sack. And boy, when teams are backed up in their goal line, you can 9 times out of 10 expect the blitz to come. And a blitz came. Benny Goods got an opening, got the sack.
Second and 14. Orville Lee was the intended receiver. And the Ticats set up at the 7-yard line will have to settle for 3.
And John Gregory's frustrated. I mean, you only get so many opportunities in a game to score. We talked about it. This was a prime opportunity to score, but the Edmonton pass rush was just too much for Damon Allen. Second time in a row, pressure on him. Leroy Blue came through, and that ball just had to be thrown before the receiver was ready.
Paul Osbaldiston, good on 10 of 16. 62%. Chip shot here. And the Tiger Cats are back in the lead. 10-7, Hamilton leading Edmonton with a minute 57 to go until halftime.
What's interesting with the Edmonton defense, they come into this game tied for the league lead in sacking the quarterback. And when they were put into a critical situation, 2 plays in a row, they got pressure from their front four, and Benny Goods, and then the pressure with the sack. Leroy Blue with the pressure to force Damon Allen to throw the ball away.
Ticats are a little frustrated with their offensive line right now. You'll recall earlier in the quarter with good field position, they got called for illegal procedure. That put them first and 15 and really out of scoring range. And that time they left Benny Goods unblocked.
Pressure on Tracy Hamm. He eludes it and looks to Armstrong. He couldn't make the catch. Coverage by Bobby Dawson. Armstrong tried to come back. There's a marker back at the line of scrimmage.
Illegal substitution. Hamilton number 26. First down.
Rico Cartwright, the normal right corner, wasn't in the game, so Ricky Royal had to come running out when he was not allowed to, so that cost them.
First down, Eskimos. The Edmonton 45. Marshall makes the catch, lost the ball, big hit. Marshall can't get it back. Sandusky might have. We'll see which way this goes. It'll be a Tiger Cat football. Big hit on Blake Marshall, and the ball sprung loose. And we're still unable to find out who recovered the ball. Another look.
Boy, not often do you see Blake Marshall get pounded like this, but Dwayne Sevens and John Moten meet at the same time and put a crunching hit on Marshall. He coughs it up. Sandusky cannot make the recovery. Tough to tell who made it. Might have been 95, Jeff Fields.
Well, John Moten has the ball right now. He's celebrating.
Well, regardless of who made the recovery, John Moten and Dwayne Simmons had a team meeting at Blake Marshall's expense. Marshall does not fumble the football too often. So the Ticats, after a field goal now with the turnover, have a chance to add to their 10-7 lead.
From the 39, Damon Allen looks to the far side. Canavere. Forced out by Jordan.
That's the kind of play that can turn a player's game around. You remember John Moten earlier in the game was called for clipping, bringing back a big Earl Winfield punt return. He's been kicking himself ever since, but that should pick him up a little.
Yeah, it's always nice to get one back when you've given up a lot of yardage through a penalty, and he comes up with the big hit.
Ticats at the Eskimo 23, Allen far side again. This time it's Earl Winfield. And there's lots to cheer about in Hamilton this season.
And a lot to cheer about the play of Earl Winfield, too. Eddie Thomas giving him lots of room. So Winfield, quick out. Damon Allen with the quick throw. And when you're running the hurry-up offense, it's a minute and 30 to go. Those are the kinds of plays you love. You get 7 yards, 8 yards. You get it out of bounds. You stop the clock. You do everything right.
Second and 3. with a minute 31 till halftime. Ticats in front by three. It's 10-7. Fake to Overlee. Allen carries himself down the sideline. Stopped near the two.
Damon Allen, the ball carrier.
Wayne Odom, number 36. In on the tackle, but the Ticats move the sticks once more. They had an opportunity moments ago from the seven. He's now they're at the four.
Play fake, and it looked like Larry Ruck might have a chance, but he just gets tripped up as he's about to make the tackle on Damon Allen, and Allen gets to the outside.
Willie Pless actually made a pretty good play on that. He was blocked out, got a hand out to slow Allen down. But here are the Tiger Cats, first and goal to go at the Eskimo four. Orville Lee. Not quite.
Well, that's good hard running by Orville Lee, though. Good surge on the left side of that Ticat offensive line. Daryl Hall, Carl, and Francois Ballanger, but Orville Lee really pounding in behind them.
Second and goal to go at the Eskimo one. Allen himself, and he might not have made it on second effort.
Allen, the ball carrier.
Well, if I'm sorry, John, if I'm John Gregory, I say go for it. Let's try and bury these guys. This is a good team we're playing against. We have to maximize our opportunities. Third and goal at the one. I have to have confidence in my offense that they can get 1 yard in a critical situation. So if he goes for it, he's sending a message to his team. He's saying, hey, offense, I've got confidence in you, and go get it. I think if you kick a field goal here, it's like bailing out.
Just want to get back up.
Well, it looks as though he's called 33, and usually the three means the fullback will carry, and the three hole, which would be to the right side, I believe, in the Hamilton Tiger Cat scheme of things.
Third and touchdown to go. Orville Lee. And confidence pays off.
John Gregory sent a real message to his offense right there. This is an offense that's struggling for identity this year, and he said, hey, I've got confidence. You guys can do it. He let them do it, and they score the touchdown. That is a big play for the Ticats. Orville Lee, he is the fullback. Right off the guard, the right guard, Jason Riley. Up over the top, the Ticats have their second touchdown of the night.
Hoss Baldiston ready to add to the total. He does, and the Tiger Cats have a 10-point lead on the visiting Edmonton Eskimos. Nice sign. Ticats surrender to no one.
Well, they're playing like that tonight. The defense has played well in the first half, and now the offense takes advantage of a late touchdown here.
A minute to go in the opening half, so there's still lots of time for the Eskimos to respond to this touchdown by Orville Lee.
Good job by Orville Lee to get up and over the top. It's been a while since I've seen a crowd in Hamilton have a good time like they're having here tonight.
Kickoff. Ezar on the return, number 35 for the Eskimos. Caught and wrestled down by Mark Dennis.
Yeah, Mark Dennis is the best player that the Hamilton Tiger Cats have on special teams. He will make at least 50% of their tackles on punt and kickoff cover.
A nifty scoring drive. Six plays to cover 49 yards.
I think, John, what's impressive about that is six plays in 35 seconds.
Absolutely.
That is really doing a good job on your hurry-up offense.
Eskimos from the 31, first and 10. Three receivers to the near side. Michael Soles, number 32, got the call. He's averaging 5.9 yards per carry, but not that time. Eskimos are the number one rushing team in the nation. Lancaster had hoped he could run a little bit against the Tiger Cats tonight. Eskimos have won one battle tonight, time of possession. This is second and nine, near side, Sandusky.
Pass is complete to Jim Sandusky.
Smart defense by Hamilton, though. There's 32 seconds left. Don't let any of the receivers get in behind you. Keep everything in front of you. Let Tracy Ham complete a few of these passes. Now, if he finally works it down the field and you find like you're getting pressured and you're going to give up some points, then you come up and play it a little tighter. But make Ham, for now, complete about three or four more passes before you play a more aggressive defense.
From the 43, Ham has room. He'll get to midfield. Stopped by Corus Irvin, number four.
Ham, the ball carrier.
And Corus Irvin did the smart thing. He took such an angle on Tracy Ham that he forced him back upfield and didn't allow Ham to get to the sidelines and out of bounds.
It'll be a first down for the Eskimos with 23 seconds till halftime. Ticats leading 17-7. From the shotgun. Ham over the middle. Sandusky makes two catches in a row. He's down to the 35.
That's a great catch by Sandusky. And these are all zone pass patterns. You get two inside receivers clearing out with the wide receivers running ins underneath them. Ham hits Sandusky. Now, 14 seconds left. Hamilton has to come up and play it tighter.
From the Ticat 36, Ham gets chased. Thrown down. It's picked off. John Moten, number 42. Markers are down as Moten continues down the sidelines. Gets away. Actually, it was Dawson. Bobby Dawson. Moten made the interception. Dawson came up with the ball after that.
Penalty marker on the play.
Zeros on the time clock right now. We won't end on a penalty. Here's Jake.
Offside pass. Hamilton. The half is over.
Moten makes the interception to stall the Eskimo drive. He handed off to Bobby Dawson. Ticats head to the dressing room with a 10-point lead.
Yo, yo, yo. I'm back again. Yes, it's me. DK Smith. I haven't gone anywhere. You thought I was gone, didn't you? Not. I'm still here, tired and true, with another edition of Entertainers Just For You. We have a wonderful show ahead of you, but first, we've got good news and we've got bad news. The good news is Steve Krupe, Chris Johnstone, hey, we're going to put you on tonight at the Improv. The bad news is O.J. Brigance, Mark Mathis. Here's the story. Secret ballot. You lose. You stink. You're banned. Never to be on a CFL show ever again in life. Psych. But we have a wonderful show for you. But first, we got to tell you about the rules as usual. And now, the rules are as follows. Wait a minute. You guys already know the rules. You know the rules by now. But we're going to show them to you anyway.
All right, Darrell, K. Smith. Remember what I told you at the All-Star Banquet down in Regina, right? You said you was going to have this thing and the best guy win. So now you're looking at the best yet.
Just warm up, see, can I still do it?
This is my last dive. And I want to thank TSN, guy from my hometown. Darryl, thank you. And I'm still going to whoop you when you come to Edmonton. And this is for you, last one. See you later, Doc. The ultimate one for Darryl K. Smith.
Yeah.
Here you go. Last one. Wham! That was some fire right there, bud. Buddy, that was real good, real good. But now, you know, we got some hard-pressed individuals here that's gonna be trying to push you out of there, you know what I'm saying? Now, from of our own representatives, from T.O., we got Rapper's Delight. We got from Hampton University, defensive back, Jonathan Smoke Wilson, and the people that you all love and know, Raghib the Rocket Ismail. From the University of Notre Dame. Take it away, fellas.
When you're kicking a freestyle lyric, only thing you need is a beat. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Check it out. Mm-hmm. One time. Mm-hmm. Bust the rhyme in the place on the mic in your face. Ask the question that I like, and I think it's a disgrace. But never mind that, cause I'm here to rap on the microphone. You know that I'm all that smoking.
Yo, the best that I might be, I might be a keep on the even a deep beat. I'm the best waiter, rhyme devastator on this show called entertainers. No, wait a minute, he's right here and I'm Smoke J. That's all I have to say. Oh, my main man DK, what's next? What's next? What can I talk about? Freestyle lyrics, busting the lights, and that's a walkabout. So as you see me on the field playing football, on the fast lines, rocket busting touchdowns. So what's next, of all my good time friends? See you on TSN. Peace.
Yeah, my boys on the mic. I know you got the like, you got to choose them as your winners tonight. Way to go, fellas. That was a fire. That was a nice route there, pal. Ooh, the decision's rough. It's going to be a hard one. But once again, we need your help. So, it's only 50 cents to make a call. Please, help us out. Now, it was the show. Did you like that one? I promised you a good one. So, look here. We didn't have Tight Cats, Rough Riders, Argos. We need some Blue Bombers. Do you guys have any talent, any at all? Except on the field, which is still questionable. We need you guys, give me something, give me something. Can you hear me out there, James West? All right, thank you again. And we'll see you next week for another edition of The Entertainers.
Hamilton opened the scoring with a great drive in the first quarter, capped off by Lee. Nice 21-yard run to make it 7-0 in favor of the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Blake Marshall got a 3-yard run of his own early in the second to tie the game at 7. But back came the Tabbies. Ballas Bollison from 21 yards out made it 10-7 in favor of the Tie Cats. And then on a third down gamble, Orville Lee with the 1-yard run, 17-7 in favor of Hamilton. And that's where we stand right now. This is young A.J. Tupper. And he's come to the game with his dad, Gary, who happened to play for the Tie Cats back in 1977. It's a family affair, and we'll be right back after these messages.
Ready for the second half at Ivor Wynn in Hamilton, our TSN Game of the Week, with the Tiger Cats in front of the Eskimos 17-7. Stats from the first half favoring the Tiger Cats, 237 yards total offense, net yards 222, a couple of turnovers by the Eskimos, who had time of possession on the Tiger Cats, but the Cats lead it on the scoreboard by 10 points. And we're ready for the second half kickoff by Paul Osbaldiston. Tiger Cat defense, rather impressive in the first half, Lee.
They did not make any mistakes. I mean, they had the one scoring drive against them, but other than that, I thought John Gregory's team played with great discipline, and of course, that is a characteristic that he brings to any team that he has coached.
Ellis and Henry Williams are deep for the Edmonton Eskimos. This time it's Craig Ellis at the 15. Behind a couple of pretty good blockers, Ellis gets out to the 35, forced back from there. Tracy Hamm did not have a terrific first half. As far as the numbers were concerned, 8 of 15 for 93 yards, one interception. Damon Allen, 7 of 16 for 123.
Really, the difference in the half between the two quarterbacks was the running of Damon Allen. He did a very good job when he was pressured to take off with the football. Tracy Hamm really did not to this point, but remember, if a game ever gets crucial, Tracy Hamm is, in my book, one of the best at lifting his team with a run.
Eskimos from the 32, and Blake Marshall got the first call of the second half.
Boy, Jeff Fields, number 95, and his partner, Mark Hall, number 70, have really done an excellent job controlling that middle. Edmonton likes to run between the guards with the big fullbacks, but tonight the Hamilton tackles have really just completely shut that down.
Two giant-sized tackles in Hamilton this year, both over 300 pounds. Second and nine. Hamm trapped behind the line. Bailey tries to run him down. Hamm on the run. And it's almost picked off and then tipped into the hands of Chris Armstrong, I believe. Wiseman got a hand on it.
Tracy Hamm's very lucky. Todd Wiseman should have had the interception. How about this? Bounces off his chest into the arms of Chris Armstrong. That will go as a reception. So what looked like a horrible play for the Edmonton Eskimo offense turns into what might be a first down after they measure.
At least close enough to measure right now.
Todd Wiseman should have had his third interception of the year.
Third down by an inch or so.
It's funny how plays like that work. You know, for Hamilton, they're saying, hey, you know, we should have had the turnover, should have had the interception. For Edmonton, they're saying, boy, what a break we had. Let's take advantage of that and get ourselves back in the ballgame. Maybe that's a good omen, a good sign for us.
Could be for the Eskimos, who have third and one. An earlier gamble paid off for Edmonton. Third, less than a yard to go for Tracy Hamm. No flags, but Hamm will have the first down without a problem. Number 98 is Mike Dumoresk, who is listed as a backup guard and wears number 53 usually. First and 10. Edmonton out now at the 44. Eskimos trailing by 10. It's 17-7 Hamilton. Good fake by Hamm. He stands in with time to throw. Sandusky at the 50. Caught from behind, inside the 45. Rico Cartwright, number 20. Hauled down Sandusky after a substantial gain, 24 yards.
Yeah, and the reason why he got that gain off to Jim Sandusky was the play of the offensive line. It's interesting when you give Tracy Hamm time to throw and he is confident. Look, he's up on that front foot. Lots of velocity on that football as he delivers it to Sandusky, but it's a simple game. Protect the quarterback and he can have a good night.
Early in the third quarter, the Eskimos on a bit of a march here after a 24-yard gain by Sandusky. He's flanked to the far side of the field now. One back in the backfield, and Hamm hands off to Michael Soles. He'll be very close to a first down. Soles averaging 5.9 yards a carry. No touchdowns so far in 92.
Watch the toaster take the inside route here, and number 60, Chris Morris, comes out on the trap, and he really didn't have to make a block on Williams. Williams took himself out of the play. Soles broke it to the outside.
Michael Soles just short of the first down. It is second and one. Three receivers to the far side for the Eskimos. Blake Marshall. And an easy first down for the Eskimos inside the Ticat 30. Marshall has the lone Eskimo touchdown on a 3-yard rush. 10-minute mark, second quarter. He's been bothered by injury and heads to the sidelines for a bit of a rest.
Yeah, he didn't look like he was feeling too well there as he left the field.
First and 10. Ham alone escapes and throws. It'll be a first down. Armstrong made the catch, number 77. 23 yards the gain. The Eskimo drive continues.
Chris Armstrong's right here. Bobby Dawson here. Watch how Armstrong works him hard to the inside and then breaks it back from the outside. Tracy Hamm has enough time as he gets out of the pocket to complete this pass, but that's pretty good work. You see how he turns Bobby Dawson completely around, and boy, that's when you've got time like that, a receiver can really work hard in the one-on-ones with the defensive back. That's a good pass pattern.
First and goal to go. The Eskimos are at the Tiger Cat 9. Ham looks back, looks to the end zone. Markers are down as the catch is made. Craig Ellis.
Now they're going to call interference on Todd Wiseman, I believe. He was all over Ellis in the end zone.
Forward pass interference. Hamilton number 6. Decline. Touchdown.
Touchdown will stand for Craig Ellis. And that's his second of the season.
Safety blitz coming. Here's Ellis. Now he sees his quarterback in trouble. He's not the primary receiver, but that is a desirable matchup. Craig Ellis on Todd Wiseman. There you see Wiseman give him the left hand, the hold. Ellis nevertheless still makes the touchdown catch, but that is not a good matchup for the Ticats to be in. Todd Wiseman on a Craig Ellis.
Back to a three-point ball game on Craig Ellis's second touchdown of the season, converted by Sean Fleming. Ticats in front, 17-14.
You know, when defenses are threatened in their own goal line area, they have to become a little more aggressive. Sometimes you get caught with it. Here's Tim Jackson, the inside safety. He is coming on a blitz. This is Todd Wiseman. He has to come over and cover Craig Ellis. Now, although Tracy Hamm rolls away, Ellis still has enough time to come all the way across the field. And even with an interference call against Todd Wiseman, he is able to make the catch. Now, he will go out of your picture, but he will come back. He's working back across the field. So what the Ticats hoped to accomplish by getting that extra pressure did not materialize, and Ellis had a good matchup against Wiseman for the touchdown. Eskimos are right back in this ballgame.
Trailing by 3 at 17-14. David Lucas on the return for the Tiger Cats. Cuts it up. Finds some room up the middle. Decent return. He's to the 39-yard line.
Happy birthday, Ray Chow. Couldn't have did it without the Newmans and the Adidas. Both number one. I told you, Ray. Vancouver. Happy birthday, buddy. See everybody in Edmonton.
It's a lot of stuff.
Yeah, you got a lot of ads in there. 11th CFL season for Craig Ellis. He's been around. 8 plays, 78 yards, time of possession 4:59. Finished off by a Ham to Ellis combination of a 9-yard touchdown toss. Ticats, first and 10, 39, Lee Knight. Number 25 carries for the Cats. He's got about 4.
Enos Jackson has a lower leg or upper leg strain, they're calling it. He's not out there right now, and it doesn't look as if he will return to the Eskimos tonight.
And that is why pretty near every team in the CFL likes to have a defensive back as their designated import, just for that particular reason. If they lose a DB, they have protection. Doug Parrish is the DI for Edmonton, and he is now replacing Enos Jackson.
Allen on second and 6. Mazzoli was the intended receiver, number 80.
And right away, a miscue in the defensive secondary of the Edmonton Eskimos. There you see Doug Parrish, who has come into the game, and a mistake was made. Mazzoli wide open, and Damon Allen would love to have that one over again. He had Mazzoli. Well, that could have been six.
Well, there were some problems with the Tiger Cats during the offseason more than anything, and they have survived one more time and have an enthusiastic response here at Iverwind tonight after winning three games in a row. They currently lead by three. Long way to go on this one. 8:49 to go, third quarter. Williams on the return. Markers are down. Mark on the play. 42-yard kick.
Illegal block. Edmonton number 43. First down.
That's Jed Roberts, usually an excellent special teams player. 22 special teams tackles last year. It'll be first and 10. Eskimos now back at the 20 as a result of that infraction. Hamilton leading 17 to 14. This is Blake Marshall. And Marshall gets to the 30, slightly short of the first down. A reminder, you can still vote on the entertainers. Who did you like? The Toronto group of Ismael and Wilson or Henry the Gizmo Williams? The numbers to call, 50 cents a call. That might be a little close tonight. What do you think?
I thought they both were good.
Better numbers for Tracy Ham, second half. Now 12 of 19 for 156 yards, one touchdown. Second and one. Marshall carried. We'll see where they spot the ball.
Leaf, you mentioned a moment ago that Blake Marshall doesn't look well. Well, he's not feeling too well. On that fumble he had in the first half, he really got rocked. In fact, he just told me on the sidelines that this Hamilton defense hits as hard as any he's seen. He's really taking a beating out there.
Gordon, I couldn't agree with you more. It seems like this is the most physical Hamilton defense I've seen in some time, and should rekindle some fond memories of great defenses of the Tiger Cats of the past. And Blake did take a huge hit from John Moulton and Dwayne Simmons on that play you alluded to.
Marshall comes up short. It'll be third down and inches to go. Eskimos just across the 30-yard line, a young Tiger Cat supporter. All decked out. Third time the Eskimos have gambled. Previous two paid off. And it looks like this one will as well. No markers anywhere. It'll be an Eskimo first down. Lancaster gambled early in the football game, deep in Edmonton territory on third and less than a yard.
Well, he is blessed with a good center in Rod Conop, and the two guards, Pierre Vercheval and Randy Ambrosi, are also excellent football players. So with defense giving a yard off the line of scrimmage and the three quality people that Edmonton have blocking in that little triangle, you know, it's a pretty safe bet.
First and 10, the Eskimos. At the Edmonton 32. Hand to his left. And Williams makes the catch. Pushed out by Rico Cartwright.
Rico Cartwright is an interesting story. Last year we told you, wide receiver with the Ticats. They converted him to a corner this year with his great speed. And you know, I really think as a teaching technique, teams should have their receivers play a little defensive back in practice and vice versa. DBs play receiver just to understand how the other side of the ball functions. And I think it would make all the players better players by doing that.
On second and one, Ham lost the ball. And the Tiger Cats may have their third turnover of the night. Mark Hall. Six-five, 305 pounds of Mark Hall comes up with a loose ball. Bad exchange between Conop and Ham.
And when there's a bad exchange, it is always the fault of the quarterback. It is never the center's fault. The quarterback has to make sure he has to snap from center before he backs away. Tracy Ham did not. Mark Hall, who says he's 305, that usually means they're about 325. He comes up for the fumble recovery.
Couple of big guys in the middle of the defense for the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Big turnover goes Hamilton's way. Welcome back to Ivor Wynn in Hamilton, where the hometown Tiger Cats lead by three, 6:09 to go, third quarter, turnover by the Eskimos. The third of the night has set the Tiger Cats up with a first down just inside the Eskimo 40. Lucas and Winfield, the two wide receivers for the Tiger Cats. Damon Allen back in a hurry. Here comes the charge, and Allen is down. Caught by Dwayne Odom, number 36. Lloyd Lewis helped set it up.
Odom making the tackle on Damon Allen.
That's pretty good for the front group of the Edmonton Eskimos. Three sacks tonight. Of course, they came in tied for the league lead in that department. They now have 18 as a group. But it seems like any time that they have been really pressured tonight and have had to come up with a good series, they've been able to do so.
Ticats now back at the 45, second and 15, facing Damon Allen. He looks deep. Cabrera down the sidelines, can't make the catch. Tight coverage on Cabrera by Murphy and Parrish.
That was just a great battle between two good football players. Ken Cabrera and Doug Parrish went up for it at the same time. This becomes a basketball jump ball play, and well, that was good coverage, and Cabrera just could not come up with a spectacular catch.
The receiver Cabrera, at least the intended receiver.
And I should add that he is from Northern Secondary High School in Toronto. My old high school as well.
Finally, a receiver out of there with blocking ability, right?
That's right.
Third down kick, waiting for it. Here's Henry Williams back at the five. Looks for room to the far side of the field. Great speed for Henry Williams. Osbaldiston missed him. Williams could go all the way, and no markers anywhere. Quick touchdown on the Eskimos. Take the lead. Pretty easy to figure that one out. He picked it up on the five. 105 yards for the touchdown by Henry Williams.
Boy, is that any good. You know, I have never seen anybody better at letting the ball roll around and really sucking that cover team in and all of a sudden picking it up and getting to the outside. And well, you want to see speed in the afterburners. How about this as he gets away from Mark Dennis at the end? Watch this. Boom. Boy, I mean, he has two speeds, fast and faster.
Add that to the Eskimo total. Edmonton in front of the Tiger Cats, 21-17.
And this deserves another look.
The Gizmo doesn't breathe when he's on a tear like this. He holds his breath for 105 yards and the touchdown to give the Eskimos the lead.
41.
Henry Williams has given the Edmonton Eskimos the lead at 21-17 with his first punt return touchdown of the season. And watch this.
Row 28, seat 5. Congratulations.
105 yards for the Giz. Could this be the TSN turning point tonight? We'll have it for you after the game, brought to you by Sony. Last chance to vote on the entertainer's phone poll. Will it be Henry Williams? Maybe he'll get a vote or two for that run as well as his performance at halftime against the Rocket and Wilson from the Toronto Argos.
What's up, Edmonton? That's your up. Lily Henry, that was for you guys. Norman, McKenzie, Matthews, the trainer, Dwayne, that was it.
The return for the Tiger Cats, Orville Lee. He gets out to the 32. Marker down.
You know, in the first half, I was talking to a member of the Hamilton medical staff who watched Gizmo return a punt. He said, you know, he's not running as well as he used to. There's something wrong with him. Well, there was something wrong with him early in the year. His hamstring was bothering him. He's fully healthy this game, and here's the news. The Gizmo can still run.
Can he ever? Bothered by the hamstring, but he seems to be okay now, folks.
I think he stretched it out nicely on that play.
Short scoring drive. Well, a long scoring drive, but in about
short fashion.
10 seconds. Ticats first and 10, 23-yard line. Paul Bushy got the call. There's a marker down on the Tiger Cat backfield, and the Eskimos may be charged for roughing on the quarterback, Damon Allen. Rob Davidson. Maybe a late hit.
Major foul, roughing the passer, Edmonton number 96.
That's exactly who it was.
Now that's a good call too. You have to protect the quarterbacks, and Rob Davidson should know better. If the ball is gone, don't hit him. Simple as that. And this is exactly what you do not want to do. You've struggled to come back and take the lead in the ball game, and you don't want Hamilton to get back into it by giving them opportunities through penalties. It's discipline. Edmonton has to have it.
Ticats out at the 43 with a first down. Allen looks to the far side. Complete. The David Lucas, forced out by Damian Lyons.
David Lucas is a newcomer in that receiving corps this year. He was at a free agent camp that the Tiger Cats signed him at. He has 4-2 speed for the 40. Damon Lyons did a nice job to come up and catch him quickly and only hold that to around 7.5 yards. But this David Lucas, he can fly.
Second down for the Tiger Cats. Second and 4, they mark it. Allen looking to Winfield. He's got it. It'll be a first down, Ticats at the Eskimo 40. Two-yard gain for Winfield. It's pretty to watch.
You want to see how a receiver works the defensive back. Watch the hard move to the inside. Look at the quarterback now break it back to the corner. He gets Eddie Thomas turned around. The pattern is called a post-corner pattern. Earl Winfield runs it to perfection. So that roughing call to Rob Davidson gave Hamilton some life, and now a nice completion to Earl Winfield. And I think Earl Winfield's a little bit ahead in that matchup. Still pretty close.
First and 10 at the Eskimo 40. Allen going to the other side. Mazzoli turns around. Forced out by Murphy. Nick Mazzoli has another Tiger Cat first down. Mazzoli in conversation with the Ticats backup quarterback Don McPherson on the sidelines and relays the message to Damon Allen. ...17 yards the pickup, first and 10, the Tiger Cats at the Eskimo 23. Mazzoli's having a good night. Pressure on Damon Allen, can he escape? Three big guys after him, he'll outrun those. Cuts it to the 10, he's to the 5! And down and out at the 1 yard line, Damon Allen has the Tiger Cats knocking at the door. 21-yard run for Damon Allen.
And this is what an agile quarterback can do for you. The blitz coming right up the middle. He's able to avoid it. Now watch the block by Earl Winfield. He is no longer a pass receiver. He's a blocker. A good block on Eddie Lee Thomas, and that allows Allen to pick up at least 8 more yards and get it down to the 1 yard line. So Damon Allen has put together a lovely drive to try and answer that punt return touchdown by Henry Williams. Hey, that's been a real factor in this game, over 100 yards.
Goal to go from the 1. Lee gets the call, his second touchdown of the game. 2 from 1 yard away for Arville Lee, and the Tiger Cats are back in the lead.
same play he scored on in the first half. Just take it in behind the right guard, Jason Riley, and then back up over the top. Dwayne Odoms, the linebacker, tries to meet him up at the highest point as he jumps, but it's not enough to keep Orville Lee out of the end zone. And give the Tiger Cats credit, they had a punt return go against them for a touchdown. That's often very deflating. But what do? They just came and marched it right back down the field themselves. That's impressive.
It certainly is. Damon Allen should get a lot of credit for that drive. It started off with a penalty, but it looked like the Tiger Cats might be in trouble and getting ready to kick the ball away again. They took advantage of the penalty and a very successful march for the touchdown.
Well, a completion to Mazzoli and then a beautifully executed corner pattern by Earl Winfield. Allen was on target, but you know, the key once again to that drive is the ability for Damon Allen to run with the football. And we showed a graphic a few plays ago where he is over 100 yards rushing tonight. It has been selective rushing and rushing when he has had to. This is an element to their offense that they simply haven't had in the past. They now have it. They are a much more effective football team.
They're rocking an Ivor win tonight. Ticats in front of the Eskimos by three. It is 24-21. The Osbaldiston kickoff coming down at the 15. Craig Ellis has a good return going for the Eskimos. Ellis gets out near the 50. We've got a game in Hamilton tonight. The scoring drive, 87 yards and five plays. And Orville Lee has his second touchdown of the night. A minute 51 to go in the third quarter.
Face mask. Edmonton number 43. First down.
Face masking call against Jed Roberts will take it back to the 40 where the Eskimos begin first down. Tracy Hamm is surrounded. He escapes. Chased down. But they can't catch up to Tracy Hamm till he gets to the 50-yard line. Mark Hall in pursuit, number 70. But he's 300 pounds and can't catch up to Tracy Hamm.
This is our first visit to Ivorwind Stadium this year, but I can tell you firsthand, guys, what a difference a year makes. These people are absolutely on their feet every play. Yeah, they've restored the roar in Hamilton. They love it here tonight.
And it looks good on them, too. They've worked hard to bring the people back here at Hamilton, and as word says, they are enjoying themselves.
Second less than a yard to go for the Eskimos. Marshall converts easily. He's across midfield and into Ticat territory. Big Blake Marshall averaging 6.1 yards per carry so far in 92.
How about that for a 230-pound fullback? That's a good average.
Absolutely. Had a big 50-yard run last week. First and 10 for the Eskimos. Ticat 54. Ham just got it away. Immense pressure.
Dwayne Simmons, the newcomer in the linebacking corps for the Ticats. Vernon Maxwell had played the first four games, or rather five games there. They released him this week. Simmons gets a chance to play, and he gets through on the blitz and forces Tracy Hamm to throw the ball away just to keep from being sacked. But the Ticats have done a good job when they have been feel like Edmonton is getting some kind of momentum. They have come with the blitz and been pretty effective with it.
This is second and 10, should be the last play of the third quarter. Ham surrounded and down this time. The toaster got there, number 91. He had some help, though. John Luton was there as well, number 42.
Well, the big key for the Ticats, they get good pressure from the outside, and that allows the big guys to come up the middle. They just folded that pocket. Tracy Hamm had no place to go.
It is the Tiger Cats by three with one quarter to go. Ann Arbor wins. Our game of the week on TSN is a great one. I'm John Wells along with Leif Pettersson and Gord Miller at Ivor Wynn in Hamilton. Ready to begin the fourth quarter. Eskimos will have to kick it away. It's third and 19. Glenn Harper across the 35. To get this one away, it is not deep. Bouncing back. Flags are all over the place. Lucas, number 82, comes up with it.
They're going to throw the flags. I think that hit a Hamilton player in the back as he was trying to go back and block. So we'll see how they sort this one out. You know, if it hits him in the back, I guess technically that is no yards.
38-yard punt that time.
Looked like 34 Ernie Schraemeyer when he was going down trying to set up some blocking. Hit him right in the back, so probably call no yards on that. There it is. Hits him right in the butt.
On the butt.
First down.
So they get 15 yards from that. That's not bad. Hamilton getting a few breaks here.
After three quarters, the numbers still favor the Tiger Cats, as does the score, 314 total yards. And the Eskimos have turned it over three times.
Doesn't feel like Edmonton's had the ball for 12 more minutes than Hamilton, though.
It really doesn't. On first down, Mazzoli makes the catch. He is short of the first down. Nick Mazzoli, pretty good night for the Tiger Cats.
Second time he's been able to catch that quick post too, and what it means is there's outside alignment by the defensive back. They quickly read it. He cuts to the inside and gets inside Stephen Jordan, makes a nice catch. And boy, in his second year, he is really blossoming. He is a big weapon for the Ticats. And he has, don't forget, he has tremendous speed.
It will be a first down, Tiger Cats at the Hamilton 53. Allen with time. Mazzoli again in front of Doug Perry. There is a marker downfield, however. Hang on one second. Looks like the call will go against number 10 for the Eskimos, Damian Lyons, in favor of the Tiger Cats here. Away from the play.
Illegal contact on an eligible receiver. Edmonton number 10. First down.
Mazzoli made the catch away from the infraction, so it'll be first and 10. Ticats at the 47. Allen has it slip out of his hands as he looked to throw. The Eskimos have recovered. Leroy Blue. It wasn't a forward pass. No markers down. Eskimos have their second turnover.
Well, what a play. David Allen with the quick roll had Ken Herrera wide open in the flat. And for some strange reason, it looked as though he was attempting to throw it. But as he was bringing it up, no, no question. The forward motion hadn't started. That's an excellent call. The fumble stands. The Eskimos get quite a break. Bring back the stick'em.
Edmonton has turned it over three times. The Tiger Cats have turned it over twice now. First and 10, Edmonton at the 49. Tracy Hamm looks deep. Almost picked off. Coverage by Rico Cartwright.
And pass is locked on by Cartwright.
Maybe the fastest guy on the Hamilton Tiger Cats is Ricardo Cartwright, and he is in a 1-on-1 confrontation with Henry Williams, who, well, you know how fast he is, but perfect position by Cartwright on the inside hip, taking away any opportunity to Williams to come back to the football.
The rap on Cartwright is a bad receiver. As a receiver last year, was bad hands. Couldn't make the catch there, but he knocked it down. Here's Tracy Hamm. No catch. Craig Ellis was the intended receiver.
Craig Ellis does a super job to find the soft spot in the zone coverage in between three tight cats. The only problem was he didn't hang on to the football. So whereas the Eskimos are always known for making the big plays in the fourth quarter, unable to do so there.
What a night Glenn Harper is having. The Eskimo punter averaging 46 yards. He'll stand back at his own 35.
Fake.
They faked it and will get the first down. Michael Soles got the call, number 32 on the fake punts. A 19-yard gain.
Mark Nelson's the special team coach with the Edmonton Eskimos, and I'm sure that was his call. Direct snap to Michael Soles. He gets a good kickout block from Blake Marshall. And the trick play works for the Eskimos, and you practice those things all week, and you get a chance to use it in the game, and it works. My, oh, my, is that a big lift for a team.
And that's a big first down for the Eskimos.
Yes, it is.
At the Tiger Cat 42. Two receivers split to the near side. Two to the top of your screen, far side of the field. Ham on a roll looking for Sandusky. Can't make the catch. Marker down. Sandusky draws a flag. Covering was number four, Chorus Urban.
You will get a good look at it here. Does Chorus Urban time it? I don't know, that's a tough one. Sandusky, the ball is underthrown. Sandusky is trying to work back to it, and then the contact is created. So what they probably call it.
Forward pass interference. Hamilton number four. 15-yard penalty. First down.
So 15 yards sets the Eskimos up at the Tiger Cat. 27. Chorus Urban caught there. Tracy Ham looks to the end zone. Batted away. Tim Jackson, number 40. Covering on Craig Ellis, number 33. That's Jackson won.
Yeah, it's tremendous acceleration by Tim Jackson. You know, he is beaten to the post initially by Ellis. Watch this, and then at the last second, Jackson is able to accelerate, get the hand up, and wow. You cannot play it any better than that. Enough confidence to stay on the outside and then make the move at the last possible second. Tough defense.
On second and 10, under the cover this time for Armstrong, no catch. Chris Armstrong, covered by Bobby Dawson. Ticats lead it by three at 24-21. Eskimos with a chance to tie it right now. 10:56 to go in the fourth quarter. The ball will be spotted on the 34 for Sean Fleming. Wide. Ticats retain the lead.
Looked as though Glenn Harper, who is the holder, had a little trouble getting that ball on the tee, and maybe that's the reason. Sean Fleming hooked it to the left side. Snap was a little low, and I think Harper just could not quite get a good handle on it. Oh, here's a good look. You're going to see it right here. Snaps down low. That's tough, and that was just enough, obviously, to upset the rhythm. Sean Fleming, and he misses.
So Fleming misses. The Tiger Cats hang out of the lead, but it narrows to two at 24-22.
In a tight football game, the Edmonton Eskimos have a very big problem on defense. We told you earlier about the problems of Leroy Blue. He wants to come out of the football game. He says he can barely run, but he can't. His backup, Mike McLean, is also hurt. So I said to Leroy Blue, what do you do? He says, you got to go and hope you don't get burned. But he's certainly not even 50% out there right now.
Leroy Blue is number 89, four sacks so far in 1992.
And of course, to compound their problems defensively, Enos Jackson is also out with the muscle pull. Doug Parrish is in replacing him. So the Edmonton Eskimos are hanging on physically on defense.
Ticats have the lead right now and the football with 10:39 to go in the fourth quarter. First and 10, Hamilton. Orville Lee. And at Ivor Wynn tonight, a rather noisy group has gathered, over 21,000 on hand for the Tiger Cats. Gain is two, this will be second and eight. Damon Allen looking deep at the 40. It's Nick Mazzoli again. Big, big play for the Tiger Cats. A 33-yard reception by Nick Mazzoli.
Tough play to cover. They're working on Doug Parrish, the inside safety, who's come in to replace Enos Jackson. And Nick Mazzoli's having a good night. Here's Mazzoli. Now he's going to do the wheel pattern. There's Lucas. He goes to the inside. Parrish just simply cannot stay with Mazzoli. There's the... Now, sometimes you get a little bit of a rub-off, too, as they did as Lucas went to the inside. But good pattern by Mazzoli. We talk about his excellent speed. Good pattern. Good throw by David Allen. And Ticats pick up a big one.
Warming up on the sidelines with the injured Damon Allen. Don McPherson wearing number 99. Allen being attended to will take a timeout at Ivor Wynn. With 9:49 to go, the Tiger Cats leading 24-22. Damon Allen heading to the Tiger Cats sideline. Shaken up on the last play.
And he didn't even get a chance to see this completion to Nick Mazzoli because Benny Goods came right up the middle, and just as the football is released, the helmet of Benny Goods comes right up and catches Damon Allen on the chin. And although he is up and walking off the field, I'm sure he is trying to shake the cobwebs out. Good shot by Benny Goods, but Damon Allen, give him credit to be able to hang into the pocket, knowing he's going to just be smacked and able to still get that football off and get the big completion.
The numbers on Don McPherson, who enters for the Tiger Cats with a first down at the Eskimo 40. Good fake by McPherson, throwing on the run, looking deep. Almost on the way down. Lucas was the intended receiver. It almost bounced into his hands as he was lying on the ground.
Might wonder why a quarterback would wear number 99, but you may be familiar with Jerome Brown, who was a defensive tackle with the Philadelphia Eagles. Back in June, he was tragically killed in an auto accident. Don McPherson and he were very good friends. So as a tribute to his good friend, Jerome Brown, Don McPherson is wearing number 99 in honor of him.
9:27 to play. Ticats by two at 24-22. Facing second and 10 with the backup, Don McPherson at quarterback. McPherson intended that for Winfield. He was covered by Eddie Thomas, number 17.
Boy, as a defensive back, I don't think you can play it any better than Eddie Thomas did. He'd been burned on that in pattern once already by Earl Winfield. He has seen it, so this time he reacted to it much better and was able to get the hand in and knock it away. The good news is the ball wasn't intercepted after the tip, and Osbaldiston will have a chance to attempt the field goal. But boy, defensively, I mean, you just cannot cover a guy any better than Eddie Thomas did right there.
Tremendous
team speed in the secondary of both these teams.
Absolutely. Todd Dillon will hold for Osbaldiston's try. A marker is down. Osbaldiston is good. 47-yard field goal for Osbaldiston.
You know, it's interesting. Harper had problems on the Sean Fleming field goal with the hold. That time, bad snap, but Todd Dillon was able to get it down. Osbaldiston adjusted his rhythm to it and made the field goal.
Procedure. Only six on the line. Repeat third down.
Oh, John Gregory.
Dillon got the ball down in time. Tiger Cats were in a wrong formation.
Well, that's great. Soft hands by your holder. And, of course, as a kicker, I mean, you're only as good as your center and your holder. And Todd Dillon did a super job to put that thing on the tee.
This time, the ball will be spotted at the 52-yard line. And this time, Osbaldiston is wide. Williams will give up the single points. And it's back to a three-point lead for the Tiger Cats.
So a penalty cost the Tiger Cats a couple of points. So frustrating for a head coach. I mean, you prepare all week, and then you hate to take points off the board, and that's what happened to the Tiger Cats. Good news is, though, they restore the three-point margin.
Yeah, and that could make it interesting as we go down to the wire here. Three points separating these two with 8:30 to go.
Damon Allen is very groggy on the Hamilton sidelines. The trainers were saying he wasn't answering questions very quickly on the field. They're going to monitor his progress and see if he's able to come back. Allen insists he's fine, but of course, they're going to be very careful.
Meantime, the Eskimo offense is on the field. And out to midfield, Michael Soles. Should be a first down.
Right in Williams by the tackle.
They'll measure. Soles has been averaging 5.9 yards a carry. It'll be a first down for the Eskimos. Ticats scored first and led 10-7 at the half. Edmonton came back to take the lead. The Tiger Cats have restored that. It's 25-22. First and 10. Tracy Ham. For Chris Armstrong. Wiseman was with him. The pass overthrown.
Safety blitz coming by Bobby Dawson. They pick it up, but Tracy Ham not able to connect with Chris Armstrong. I mean, that is a good matchup for Edmonton. Armstrong against Todd Wiseman. They just weren't able to hit it.
Second and 10 for the Eskimos. Just shy of midfield. Ham with time. Sandusky, the intended receiver. A bit of a mix-up. Corus Irvin moved in and ended up being closer to the pass from Ham than Sandusky did.
One thing you have to remember, too, with those two big tackles, getting that push up the middle into that pocket. You've got Mark Hall at 6'5" and Jeff Fields at 6'3". Now, they were coming in the face of Tracy Ham, and he simply had to throw it over the top of. There's Mark Hall. There's 6'5". And of course, you put your arms up. He's over 10 feet. Ham had to throw over top of him to get the ball away, and the ball was just far too high.
Hard to believe you can be 6'3 and 300 pounds on the defensive line and be the second biggest guy out there.
That's right.
As is Jeff Fields. Glenn Harper's kick. Winfield takes it. No markers down. Now they come down, and Winfield steps out near the 25. 35-yard punts. 5-yard return. And tempers flare on the far side by the Tiger Cat bench.
We got a good fight going down there. Ricky Royal blocked his man right down into the dugout there, and then the punches started flying.
Doug Parrish.
Obviously, it was Parrish whom Ricky Royal was blocking, but Royal just took him right down the steps into the dugout.
We'll check out the infractions here after the play. Timeout on the field. It may take a second or two to sort things out. We'll do just that when we return to Ivor Wynn and Hamilton with 7:13 to go. The Tiger Cats lead by three.
He scored a punt return touchdown in the second half, but of more concern to the Gizmo, he won the entertainer's phone poll. Final result 682 to 188 for the Giz, who's asked us about 10 times in the second half how he was doing.
Well, you won, Giz, and Damon Allen is back for the Tiger Cats. Penalties appear to be offsetting because the ball is spotted just near the 25 where Winfield stepped out of bounds. Doug Parrish of the Eskimos was in the middle of the practice that happened at the Tiger Cat bench.
There you see the numbers from Damon Allen's performance tonight, 216 yards in passing. Not the best night, obviously, that he's ever had, but where he has been effective, that he personally owes over 100 yards rushing tonight, and he has been selective. He's been very good rushing the football, and right now that's the difference in this game.
Allen unloads for Winfield. He takes it on the dead run, caught from behind at the 40. A big game for the Tiger Cats. I guess Damon is okay.
Has been having a good year running that post and fly pattern, and Damon Allen nothing more than step back and let it fly for Earl Winfield. Good catch. Eddie Thomas cannot stay with him right there. The Ticats, give them credit. They have really been making the big plays when they've had to tonight, and with that catch, I would clearly give Winfield the upper hand in that battle. But the good teams make the big plays late in the game, and that one was a huge one for the Tiger Cats.
Cats first down at the 40. Allen is caught from behind by Lloyd Lewis.
Lloyd Lewis with the sack on Damon Allen.
And that's a coverage sack. Coverage downfield on Nick Mazzoli as Allen wanted to let the ball go. He just simply wasn't open, and that allowed Lewis that extra little bit of time to come in and get that sack.
Fourth sack of the season for Lloyd Lewis. Earl Winfield slightly shaken up on the last play. He has a Charlie horse and being attended to on the sidelines. This is second and 18. Far side, Richard Nurse, did he stay in bounds? I don't believe so.
Really shows you the depth of the Tiger Cat receiving corps. You know, a year ago, they were really struggling to be able to field enough good receivers out on the field. Now Winfield goes out for play. His replacement, Richard Nurse, comes in the game. He catches a pass and picks up a first down. So, you know, your depth of a ball club is much better in 92 than it was a year ago.
Picked up 16, but the Ticats needed 18. So it'll be third down and just over a yard to go. 5:22 remaining, and Osbaldiston will get a chance to add to the Hamilton lead. Dylan Holding at the 39. Definitely within Osbaldiston's range. He's on target and good. ...28-22 now, the Tiger Cats in front of the Eskimos. Just over 5 minutes to play. Winfield walking it out from the sidelines. He made the big play to set up that field goal.
That's a great catch he made. So now the Tiger Cats force the Edmonton Eskimos to score at least a touchdown to take the lead.
Henry Williams flanking to the far side of the field, top of your screen. Eskimos down by six with a first and 10. The Edmonton 35, play action. Blake Marshall, bit of a mismatch. Marshall against Rico Cartwright, but Cartwright got him out of bounds. No tackle, he just pushed him out.
Well, you're right, Rico Cartwright did a nice job to get out there and stop Blake Marshall. Looked like Marshall had a lot more room. Pick up extra yardage. Craig Ellis, well, he got in John Moten's way anyway.
The gain is 8, second and 2. Eskimos at their own 43. John Moten's had a good game for the Tiger Cats. This is Marshall, and I don't think he got the first down. He ran into the Twin Towers for two, Mark Hall and Jeff Fields. The 300-pounders in the middle.
You add in the fact that on second and two, you get the defensive ends, both David Bailey and Brett Williams pinching down. It sure doesn't create a lot of running room in the middle.
Mark Dumares, number 98, is in. So it looks like the Eskimos will go gambling on third down, about a yard to go. It's a short one. Fourth gamble of the night for the Eskimos on third and short.
And they've made three.
And they're three for three. Gotta like their chances. No markers anywhere. And it looks like it will be an Eskimo first down.
Well, the first down.
Good job, good job. Way to work, way to work.
No problem, right, Ron?
Four for four.
First and 10. Eskimos just across the 45 now. Hamilton leading by six at 28-22. Lots of time to go. 3:24 remaining. Ham for Ellis. And he makes the catch at the 25. Ellis in front of Tim Jackson. 38 yards for Craig Ellis, his biggest catch of the night.
Ticats come with the blitz. Tracy Ham sees it right away. One-on-one coverage. He rolls to the wide side. Throw back to the corner pattern to the short side of the field with Craig Ellis, who runs it perfectly. Tim Jackson cannot stay with him. So the Edmonton Eskimos, with just 3 minutes remaining, come up with the big play as they trail by six. A touchdown will put them ahead.
Timeout at Ivor Wynn in Hamilton. Eskimos threatening to take the lead once more. They're trailing by six. We're back here next Wednesday night with the CFL report, kicking off things live from Ivor Wynn in Hamilton, getting set for the Tiger Cats' next home game against the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. And that could be a rather important game, depending on the outcome of things in week six. So we look forward to week seven already. CFL on TSN live from Ivor Wynn, and it's great to see this kind of enthusiasm back in Steeltown.
Yeah, fun place to come to.
First and 10 for the Eskimos. The ball at the Tiger Cat 26. 3 minutes and 5 seconds to go. Hamilton leading by six. The Eskimos on a pretty good roll here. Good drive for Tracy Ham. He hopes to keep it going. Far side. And it is a completion to Craig Ellis.
Pretty smart move by Tracy Ham, too. He's expecting pressure coming when the Tiger Cat defense is backed up. So he decides to try and roll away from it. It creates a better sight line for him downfield. And he has Craig Ellis to the outside on the out pattern. Pretty easy ball to complete, although Ellis had to go high to make a good catch. But smart by Tracy Ham to move that pocket around.
From the 13 now, after a 13-yard gain. Eskimos first and 10. Ham looks to the 5-yard line. Another completion, this to Sandusky in front of Corus Urban. Damon Allen can only watch as the Eskimo offense drives for the touchdown.
Pretty nifty. Chris Armstrong and Sandusky line up in an I formation to try and confuse the coverage, and that makes Corus Urban back off and gives Sandusky lots of room to run the out pattern on the outside. Tracy Ham with, once again, another good delivery, and although Sandusky has not had a huge night, big play there to make the catch and put his team in great scoring position.
A goal line stand for the Tiger Cats. Eskimos will get three cracks from the two. They'll need at least one more. The ball is loose. Ticats indicate they have recovered. And they have.
Whoa.
A couple of times tonight, there has been a problem in the Eskimo backfield on the exchange. Lancaster cannot believe his misfortune here.
Bobby Dawson, number 27, the halfback, comes sliding all across and hits Marshall pretty near when he takes the handoff. The ball is loose. The Ticats recover, and don't think there's 21,000 people in Hamilton aren't too happy about this one. Watch Bobby Dawson, the left of your screen. He slashes right down, and he is the one who makes the hit, knocks the ball loose.
And Todd Wiseman comes up with a football, number 6. Ticats goal line stand works. First and 10, Hamilton, beginning at their own 2. Allen with time comes to the near sideline. Mazzoli. It's his 7th catch of the night. 7 for 116 for the pride of Markham District High School, the Marauders.
Oh, what a great throw by Damon Allen. Larry Ruck was sliding out from the inside linebacking spot, and he just was not able to get a finger on it. Mazzoli with the catch, so the Ticats get a little breathing room. They're still second and short, but he has had a nice evening. 7 catches, 116 yards, and he has blossomed in his sophomore season.
Second and 1. Allen hangs on and should have the first down as the Tiger Cats would like to take some time off the clock. It shows 2 minutes 16 seconds to go.
And this will really show the grit of a football team. How far have the Ticats come early in 1992? They have a 6-point lead. They are deep in their own territory and would certainly love to put at least one, possibly two more first downs together before they have to give up the football.
Ticats at the 13. First down. This is Orville Lee. He's across the 15, almost to the 18-yard line.
Could be the down of the ball game right here.
Looks like a 5-yard gain. Second and 5.
2:02 on the clock. Plenty of time for the Edmonton Eskimos to score a touchdown should they get the ball back. And with the clock now running under 2 minutes, huge play for both teams.
And a 6-point ball game. Allen, far side. Coming out of the backfield, it'll be a first down for Orville Lee. Good-looking Tiger Cat fans everywhere.
Oh, what a great play. That's why Orville Lee is a starter. He ran the football for 5. Now he makes a good catch. That catch was a lot more difficult than it appeared. He's able to hang on. The Ticats get the first down. Large, large play.
First catch of the night for Lee. It's good for 12 yards. But a big catch. First and 10 from the 29. Lee Knights with a minute 22 to play. Ticats lead it by 6 at 28 to 22.
And oh, so critical. You saw the face of Ron Lancaster. He knows that his defense has to make the play right now. They have to shut Hamilton down. There you see the time on the clock.
Second and 9, and Allen goes for the bunch. Oh! Winfield almost put it away for the Tiger Cats.
Okay, that's what Edmonton wanted. They needed to get Hamilton to give up the football. They have a minute and 8 to go. Plenty of time for Tracy Ham. We've seen him do it time and time again. Damon Allen looked as though he had Winfield home free. See if Eddie Thomas just got a hand on it at the last second. I'm not sure he did.
So Damon Allen is through for now, possibly for the evening. 17 of 29. A minute 8 to go. Ticats have to kick it away. Osbaldiston, Thomas touched it. Now it bounces to the gizmo. Henry Williams, and no return for Williams, at least not much. He stopped at the 35.
Great downfield coverage by number 33, Paul Bushy. Boy, when you need a big play on special teams, he delivered as Henry Williams just had no running room. So the Edmonton Eskimos have a long way to go. Boy, I've watched them so many times over the year, and boy, at this stage of the game, exactly a minute to go. This is the time when Tracy Ham seems to take over and run with the football. Don't be surprised if he takes it upon himself right here.
First and 10 Eskimos beginning at the 35. They trail by six. Less than a minute to go. This is Michael Soles making the catch coming out of the backfield. He ran into a wave of Ticat tacklers and is stopped short of the first down. You've said it before that if you had limited time on the clock and a quarterback to choose to run this hurry up offense and get you the points you need, it would be Tracy Ham.
Well, there's some good ones around. Tracy, I tell you, he does a great job at it.
50 seconds to go. The Eskimos are down by six. Ham over the middle. And it'll be a first down for the Eskimos. Blake Ezor made the catch. He's number 35.
Come on, defense!
43 seconds to go. The Eskimos have a first down at their 46. Ham sprints to his right, firing on the run, and he fired low for Chris Armstrong.
And enough pressure from number 94, David Bailey, that Ham could really not step up on that front foot and deliver the football with as much velocity as he would have liked to. David Bailey kept a good outside leverage, the good pressure, and that resulted in a poor throw by Tracy Ham. So, every play, it seems like it's getting larger and larger.
Well, this one is big, second and 10. 37 seconds left on the clock. Ham needs a first down. Looking for Williams down the sideline. He's in behind the cover. He makes the catch. He'll score the touchdown. Can you believe it? Henry Williams. A 68-yard touchdown. It's 28-28 with the convert to come. Rico Cartwright was covering on Williams. Tracy Ham went for the bundle.
Can you believe it? Hard to believe that a defensive back can let a receiver get in behind him, but Gizmo Williams timed it perfectly. He shields off Rico Cartwright for that football, and then goes up and out jumps him for it, and 105-yard punt return for a touchdown. Wow.
Ticats will try and block the convert. The Eskimos look to take the lead. Here's Sean Fleming.
They got it.
It's blocked. Picked up and run into the end zone by Harper. The Eskimos get the point. That's the hard way to go about it. Glenn Harper coming up with a loose ball and the two-point convert.
Can you believe it?
John Gregory is having a hard time believing what's happened to the Tiger Cats in the last 20 seconds.
And really, you know, people may say, well, that's fairly insignificant, this two-point convert. Great block.
Heads up by Harper, though.
Oh, yeah. But this is significant. If Hamilton had time to come down and try a field goal and miss, you know, they're only a single away from overtime. Now they need the field goal to win it outright.
Eskimos lead it 30-28. A great finish ahead in Hamilton. 27 seconds remaining. Henry Williams got the big touchdown, 68 yards from Damon Allen. That got the Eskimos within one. The convert blocked by their Tiger Cats, but Harper picked up the loose ball and carried to the end zone for two.
Well, Gizmo did such a super job to shield off Rico Cartwright and then allow himself better position to go up and make that catch. That was truly a remarkable play.
Ticats could use a big return here with time running out. This is Orville Lee. And Lee gets to the 43-yard line.
Well, the Eskimos late in the game come up with some huge plays, heads-up plays. Block kick by number 20, Rico Cartwright, and then Harper alert enough to pick it up, and that's a two-point convert.
22 seconds remain.
Hamilton needs about 25 yards of offense to give us Baldiston an opportunity.
Ticats beginning at the 42. Damon Allen looking deep.
and over the head of Nick Mazzoli. 17 seconds to go. Ticats down by two. Biggest play for the Tiger Cats so far tonight. Second and 10 at the 41. Allen, time to throw. Far side, it's almost intercepted. Intended for Winfield. And Dwayne Odom got in the way. They call it an interception and a fumble.
Dwayne Odom, number 36. With the interception and, you know, quite frankly, about a minute and a half ago, I thought Hamilton was going to win this football game, and I'm sure John Gregory did too. And the Edmonton Eskimos, to their credit, just have come up with some huge plays late in the game to pull this one out. And there's the interception by Dwayne Odom, his first as an Edmonton Eskimo. He fumbles the ball, but Eddie Thomas is there to make the recovery, and that is the ball game.
6 seconds to go. The Eskimos just have to waste that much time to post their fifth victory of the season. ...30-28. That'll be the final score. Boy, the long pass from Tracy Hamm to Henry Williams on second and 10. 68-yard touchdown as Williams got in behind the coverage of Rico Cartwright. Cartwright came back on the next play, blocked the convert, and then Harper picks up the loose ball and goes in for what will be the winning points. So the Hamilton Tiger Cat win streak ends at three games. They were close on this night, but Lancaster comes through with a win. And the Edmonton Eskimos are top dogs in the Western Division of the Canadian Football League. Great way to start off week number six. A great finish and Ivor win in Hamilton.
Then Turning Point brought to you tonight by Sony Trinitron. It's the fourth quarter. The Edmonton Eskimos are down by six. Tracy Hamm goes back and looks to see the gizmo working on Rico Cartwright, who gambles and loses. The result, the touchdown that ties the game, an unlikely two-point conversion would follow. And the Eskimos pull one out in Hamilton. A cash donation will be made to the Coaching Association of Canada for the training and development of Canadian coaches in amateur sports on behalf of TSN and Sony Trinitron, perfecting the sport of watching TV. The Gizmo joins us now. Hey, you won the Pepsi Entertainers Bowl and you caught the winning touchdown pass. Not a bad night.
Well, you know, I've been always wanting to get a chance where we was behind and I can come back and do something, you know, to put us back in the game. And unfortunately, Tracy came to me that time. I just had to concentrate on the ball.
How much better are you as a wide receiver than you were, say, late last year?
I'm about the same. The thing about it, they give me a lot of work out there. Last year, I only went in when a guy got tired or something. Now I'm out there the whole time, and I'm able to look at the defense covering me a lot and just, you know, making some plays. That's the most important thing.
The winning touchdown reception, a 105-yard punt return for a touchdown. Do you feel completely healthy?
Not really, but I'm just, you know, people might think I'm dogging it, but yeah, I'm hurting, but still, that's what we get paid for. You got to play hurt sometime.
Boy, can't wait to see you healthy. Gizmo, thanks very much. Congratulations.
Thank you. And don't forget my tie, okay?
You got it. Right. Henry the Gizmo Williams gets one of these. And the Eskimos get the win. We'll be back, Ivor Wynn, in just a moment.
What a terrific finish at Ivor Wynn Stadium in Hamilton as the Eskimos come from behind to win it by two. What a way to win a football game, and what a tough way to lose one for John Gregory and the Hamilton Tiger Cats. It looked like the Tiger Cats might be able to hang on and pull that one off until Allen connected with the Giz.
Well, you know, very unfortunate for the Hamilton Tiger Cats, but, you know, they committed a cardinal error at the end of the game. Rico Cartwright, now he's a first-year corner, but really, when it's that late in the game and you know Edmonton has to score a touchdown, there's very little time left on the clock, you simply can't let a guy get in behind you. He let the Giz, I mean, Giz has got great speed, yeah, no doubt about that, but Cartwright has great speed too. But that's a mistake that it's a costly mistake and a very tough way to learn, but I think the next time Rico Cartwright's
situation, he's going to say, hey, that guy's not getting in behind me, but give the Giz credit. What a super job as a receiver. You know, Gord Miller asked him, are you better this year? And he said, no. Hey, he is better because he's doing the little things better. Little things. Shield the guy off, then make the move at the end absolutely. Like he did. That was good.
And then when it looked like we might face overtime and Cartwright had blocked the convert try, Harper ran into the end zone, and that provided the Edmonton Eskimos with the winning margin in a thrilling come-from-behind victory over the Hamilton Tiger Cats. The Eskimos are number one in the West.
It was an absolute war out there, a war won once again by the Edmonton Eskimos, who have made a habit of picking the Hamilton Tiger Cats' pockets here at Iverwind Stadium. Our next game is right back here next week. The Ticats will be hoping for better luck. We'll start off with the CFL report at 7 o'clock Eastern Time. And after that, it's the Ticats and the Blue Bombers at 7:30 Eastern Time. The final score, the Edmonton Eskimos 30, the Hamilton Tiger Cats 28. All of us at TSN, thanks for tuning in, and good night from Iverwind Stadium.